or talking about Adam Larsson. Bruce, what's your secret good thing for Adam Larsson?
Oh, it's such a secret that as an old goalie, I really like the defensemen that play with a little bit of edge and make the opposing forwards pay for their incursions into the offensive zone, let alone the blue paint. And Adam Larsson is one tough son of a gun to play against. What I like about him, though, is that he doesn't lose position running around looking for that big hit. He takes the hit every time that he can, but it's just one of an arsenal of defensive weapons that he has at his disposal. Body position, good defensive stick, filling the lanes, clearing the side of the crease so the goalie can see the shot, but also taking his pound of flesh when it's there to be taken.
Gotta have it. My secret good thing, Bruce, is he was drafted. He was talked about as maybe being the first overall pick in his draft year, and it was because, not just because he was a good defensive player, but because he had some real offensive potential. When Larsson is freed up, I think we see a player who's really, really smart with the puck, can make a good play in the offensive zone, can walk the line, can get it. He doesn't have a great shot, never will have one, I don't think. But he can make a really good pass, both in his own zone and in the offensive end. So that's my secret good thing about Larsson, is the kind of latent offensive skills that I think are going to start to emerge in the next couple years. And what would you say his obvious bad thing is? Did anything stick out for you?
Well, I guess offensively, just maybe that little lack of execution, like you say, his poor shot. And just when he does move around in the offensive zone, he creates problems for the other team, but not often does it wind up with Larsson getting a 10 bell scoring opportunity or a goal.